Welcome to this brief guide on how to use shape effects in PowerPoint. If you've got your PowerPoint presentation basically all ready to go, but you'd really love for your title slides to have that extra bit of punch, well today I'm going to show you some super simple shape effects that you can use to make your title slides stand out. In my first example, I'm going to head to the Insert menu in our ribbon, and we're going to use the video option and select the option for stock videos. We'll start with a base of a stock video, overlay some shapes and effects on top of that. I'm going to create a bit of a beach scene here, so I'm going to insert this beach video. If I'd like to play the video and see what it looks like, I can always hover down the bottom here and select the play bar. Now that I've got my video inserted, we're going to head back to the insert menu, select a shape option, and we're going to insert a rectangular shape. In this case, I'm going to insert it over about half of my slide. And now that I've got my shape inserted, I'm going to remove the outline using the Shape Outline menu item. And then I'm going to use the Shape Fill option, and I'm going to change it to a bit of a darker blue, so that way it's got a bit more contrast in comparison to my video. And now I just need to make sure I've selected the shape, because that way I will have my Shape Format menu option in the ribbon, and then I can use the Edit Shape option. If you wish, you can completely change your shape to a different style, or we can use the Edit Points option, which is what we'll use here. Selecting this is going to give your shape a red outline. Now this red outline is important because you can hover your mouse anywhere over this outline and click and drag. Clicking and dragging is going to allow you to customize the shape to meet your needs. In this case, I'm going to add a bit of a curve to it to match the sort of beach and wave aesthetic. And then I can use these handles to have more granular control over the angle of my curve, such as going all the way back to a very steep curve there. I'm just going to leave it as a nice wavy sort of curve. And now that I've got the shape sorted, we need to add our title. In order to do so, we're going to head to the Insert menu, and we're going to insert a generic text box and just overlay it across our slide. We then want to choose a nice big prominent font. I'm going to choose a Masus MT Pro Black. And then we're going to choose the font size, make it nice and large. So let's go with 96. And I'll type in the title that I want for my slide, which in this case is going to be Beach Time. Now I just want to make sure that I overlay the text across my shape. So as you can see, I'm having them nice and overlaid here, and there's a reason for that, which will become apparent real soon. Now that I've got both of them there, I want to hold down Shift, select my text, and select my shape. And then we're going to use the Shape Format menu item. But instead now, we're going to select the option that says Merge Shapes, and then select the option that says Combine. And this will give me the effect that I'd like. However, what I've noticed is that the shape has taken on the black color from the font. I'd like it to be the other way around. So I need to keep in mind that the order in which I select my shape and my text does matter here. So I select the shape first, select the text, and then head back to that Merge Shapes option and select Combine. And as you can see, I now have this awesome negative space effect where the shape and the text has been combined, and playing the video behind it gives me this really cool effect. Now for our second example, we're going to combine a couple of effects to get something that's a little bit more advanced. To begin with, we head to the Insert tab and insert a text box because we're going to start off by putting in our title. In this case, I'm going to select a different font. We're going to make it nice and large. Let's go with size maybe 130. And you guessed it, the title for this slide is going to be Mount Fuji. Now, normally, a lot of people would just simply take their title, move the title into the middle of the slide, and in this case, maybe change the color of the font to something like white so it's got a little bit more contrast. But it's not that exciting. So let's see what we can do to make this really stand out. In this example, I'm actually going to copy this over and I'm going to put it onto a black background just so it's easier for you to follow along and see the effects as I apply them. So the first thing I'll need to do here is select all of my text, and just like we did in the first example, we're going to make use of the Shape Format menu item. But in this case, we're going to use the Word Art Styles, and we're going to use one of the preset options in the text effects. I'm going to start off with a nice little glow effect here. But as you can see, the glow effect doesn't match the color of my font. So I'm going to change that up a little bit here, and I'm going to simply hit that text effects option again, select glow, but in this case, I'm going to choose more glow colors and I'm going to make it a white so it matches the color of my font. And now that I've got the font sorted, I'm going to head to the insert tab in my ribbon and we're going to insert a shape. In this case, we're going to overlay a shape over the top of the text itself. And when I rotate this around, you'll see it looks kind of like a volcano. A thing to note here is that in this example, the color of this shape will not play an effect on our end result, so it doesn't matter what color it is. Now that I've got this all lined up, I want to head over and I want to duplicate the slide. Now the reason for this is we're going to make some adjustments on the second version of this slide and then combine them together. The first thing I'll want to do is change the color of this font. So I'm going to change the font to a nice deep red. And you guessed it, I'm also going to change the glow effect in the shape format options and make that a nice deep red as well. And now for this next component, the order in which we select our items does play a role. So for this first one, we want to make sure that we select the text first and then hold down shift and then select our shape. So we want to select that shape format, merge shapes, and in this case, we're going to choose intersect so that we're left with the piece of text that was intersected by our shape, which you can see we have here. And on the other slide, we're going to select our text, hold down shift, select our shape. But in this case, we're going to choose subtract from our merge shapes option. So this is going to subtract the section of the shape from our original text. So now we simply select the red piece. We're going to cut that out of there and we're going to then simply paste it into our other slide. And as you can see, it lines up perfectly. And now all we need to do is simply select both of these items whilst holding down the shift key. We can then right click. And in the context menu, we can select the option that says group in order to group them together. Then we have one item that we can simply cut out of there, head back over to our original slide and paste it in. And now we can just blow it up to make it nice and big. And we have this sort of Japanese flag aesthetic that we can utilize to really make this title slide stand out. And then our third and final example is going to be the most involved of all. We're going to combine a whole bunch of different effects to make use of negative space. So here I have the word negative typed up. But as you can see now, all of these letters are in their own individual text boxes, so I can move them around independently of each other. The reason for this is that I want to actually move them all around so that all of the letters are overlapping with each other in some way. I then use Ctrl A on my keyboard to select all of the letters. I then use the Shape Format menu item. We're going to go to Merge Shapes, and we're going to select the option at the top that says Union. This is going to combine all of these letters into one big shape for me to use on my title slide. We're then going to head to the Insert menu, select Shapes, our rectangular shape like we did in the first slide, but in this case, we're going to cover the entire slide. And also, we're going to utilize that Shape Fill option, but instead of a single solid color, we're going to choose one of the options in the Gradient category. We'll then need to right-click on this gradient shape and choose the option that says Send to Back. Now, we want to select all of the items on our slide, head to Shape Format, Merge Shapes, and then we're going to choose the option that says subtract. So we're now subtracting the text from our gradient. Now we're going to take it another step further and we're going to insert another stock video just like we did in our first slide. But in this case, we're going to choose a different video. I think maybe this orange and green wavy video here. This looks pretty cool. So we're going to select this video, choose insert, and it'll take a couple of seconds to download. But once it's downloaded, just like we did with the gradient shape, we want to right-click on the video file and choose the option that says Send to Back. And whilst I could stop here, because we have that negative space effect working for us, we can take this a little bit further. We can select our shape, choose Shape Format, Shape Fill, Gradient, and then choose the option that says More Gradients. This will give us our Format Shape sidebar, where we can now choose to customize our gradient with extreme granularity. So as you can see here, I can choose each of the individual stops on my gradient, and then using the transparency slider, I can adjust the transparency levels in individual areas of my slide, allowing me to see a bit more of that background video while still keeping the effect of my negative space. And in order to ensure that my title continues to stand out and be visible, I can adjust the brightness level of the individual stops on my gradient. So as you can see, I'm getting this nice dark effect around my title, but my title maintains its prominence in the middle of my slide while still allowing you to see that video that's sitting in the background. And whilst it's taken a little bit of effort to get this effect working, if you ask me, it's totally worth it. And that is our third and final example for this video. So just to recap, we've gone through being able to combine shapes. We've talked about being able to intersect and subtract shapes. And then in our last example just then, we've done the union and subtraction options. I hope you found these tips extremely useful and you make use of these in your next presentation to make your title slides the best they've ever been. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.